Hey everybody, welcome back to the Nintendo vs. Sega series. This is the Chilling Retro Gamer, and I'm gonna be playing Heavy Metal on the arcade. I'm gonna be providing a short gameplay of this game, since it's one of those old games which have no continuation feature. I think it has an ending, but actually it's kinda tedious to try to get it. Let's go. Sega game, as you can see, it's not a co-production. It was made in 85. It has four main levels, but each of them actually takes quite a lot of time if you don't do things properly. Holy piss! This special missile you're able to shoot. I have those sort of yellow or blue squares at the left, right, are the amount of missiles you have available to shoot. They're useful especially against the boss, but of course you can kill certain annoying enemies using it. And if you run out of missiles, you have to wait. This is a sort of little green bar, as you can see. That's pretty much the time you have to wait for it to reload. Okay, that shit is already destroyed, so I don't have to use it anymore. I mean, I don't have to use it against that sort of base. Okay, that was an accident. There was an accident! There we go. So as I told you, this game doesn't have continuation features, so if I die, I have to continue from a checkpoint. And that's why this game becomes a bit tedious and boring after 10 or 20 minutes, playing it. Just clear the first part. Okay, now I gotta deal with helicopters. These are sort of mini areas. Of course, once you are done with one, you continue to the next one, which is a sort of checkpoint already. And after you complete the four mini areas, you fight a boss, which is basically the same in the main levels. Okay, as you can see, these are the little four areas. Now we are in the forest. Gotta be careful. Normally, make a mistake. I try to shoot at the enemies, but I'm not aware of the bullets they are shooting at me, so I don't avoid them, and of course I die because of them. Gotta be careful with that. See? I was trying to shoot at the enemy and I forgot about avoiding for the most part. I was close. Oh god damn it! I really hope I can beat this first level in this video. I could use the invincibility cheat, which is it's not a cheat as such. I mean, it is a cheat, but I mean, there is an item you can get. You saw at the beginning those there are little color balls you can get for you to get certain improvements, such as power up, speed up, a little base. Those things shoot at you, these balls. What did he get? This is exactly what I was about to point out. I got invincibility, which is basically a shield. I don't know if you are actually invincible or it takes a certain amount of hits. But yeah, there is a cheat for you to get infinite shield, so it's not invincibility as such. It's basically that you are shining like this the whole time. These are like conveyor belts. So this is the third area. I was able to pass the second one without so much trouble, actually. I used to have a lot of trouble in the forest. I actually made it like in the second try, or I already lost the shield. Probably takes a few hits, actually. And of course, using infinite shield, it's like using invincibility cheat, yeah. This is the third area, as you can see. I got a little power up right in the conveyor belt-like things. Son of a... Oh! Damn. I become slower, of course, so it's more difficult for me to avoid those missiles aiming my ass. There we go. Son of a bitch! Nope! Oh yeah, I can shoot at the missiles, so the bullets are shooting at me as well. It's kinda risky, but yeah, you can do that. Alright, with one missile. Actually, you can shoot with your normal bullets to those giant things. Okay, now I got power as such. Okay, that was pretty gay. but I'm about to make it. I haven't used any missile or all of, just one once in a while, because I have to save them for the boss battle. That's the whole point. Alright, that was really pathetic. What did I get? Well, it doesn't matter. I'm the only chill I'm using at the moment is infinite lives for me to be able, if, to be the first boss. And the first level as a consequence, of course. I was practicing a little bit before. I did a live stream on this just for showing the game, shits and giggles. And yeah, it took me like 20 minutes or something, 15 minutes even, like an average, if you will, to get to the second level. It's basically for testing myself the amount of tries it would eventually take me to make it. Okay, here it is, I think. I still suck at this game, that's a fact. Okay, that was so fucking close. Shit, 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 shit. So I'm almost there, gotta be careful. Okay, I got to destroy that. How can I aim those shooters with a missile? Shit, how did I survive that? I gotta shoot at these things, actually. Gonna get the fuck out. Oh, okay, that was almost a dream for me to avoid all of those things. Alright, how about using this right here? No, not yet. Shit, 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 shit. I gotta use it, man. That part would be impossible without. Oh! Alright, range. I can control the range by holding the missile button thing. No, too much range. Again. I destroyed two of them, not all of them. Ugh. But it keeps destroy, that's a good thing. Alright, let me try again. There we go. What did he get? Ah, speed up. It tells you at the left, as you can see, what you got by grabbing that little item. Okay, this should be easier this time. I still can die. These flying things are annoying, as you can see. Damn. Oh! What the fuck? Oh, don't tell me I got, squished. My screen. I probably did. Yeah, I can destroy the bullets with my own bullets. That's risk, anyway. Gotta keep shooting a shitload of stuff, bullets, myself. Yeah, this is so complicated, actually. I should just try and avoid all the bullets. I don't think these flying things actually touch me and go for myself, I mean. Just the bullets. Yeah, I gotta be careful, man. I'm not making any progress. I have to pass the entire part and fight the boss. But yeah, this is, it's gonna be a little bit of a challenge. I have so much time, but at least I want to show you the boss. How the boss looks like. And what you are supposed to do, it's not that complicated, it's not a big deal, but yeah. And basically, I want to show something more or less complete. Through this little gameplay of this game. Okay, I think I probably got a checkpoint already. Scrolling is kind of slow, okay. Shit. Oh, wait, the flying things as such don't kill me, just the bullets. Okay, whatever. I made it to the boss. You're supposed to use the bullets when it's assembled. When the pieces are separated, you try not to do anything. Because nothing is gonna work. And the color is gonna change. It's gonna get more reddish. I have quite a few missiles still, but as I said before, shoot when it's assembled. Oh, I need to charge? Don't tell me I ran out of missiles. Yes, I did. Actually, those squares, as I said before, don't represent the amount of missiles you got, but yeah. Of course, you got an aimer. Oh, son of a bitch, I didn't see that coming. I got one more minute. Let me give a try at least. Alright. Oh, wait. It's like one more hit and it's dead. So yeah, right into the middle. Probably it's saving the hits? Every time I die? Probably, man. I wouldn't be surprised. Probably not. I'm just probably shooting in a proper way, yeah. Just getting normal colors. Well, I can shoot a lot of times, actually. It's like a time stopper. Yeah, I made it. There we go. Just on time, baby. So yeah, this is basically what the game is about. The locations change a little bit, but the game is pretty much the same most of the time. It's actually fun for the time it came out. So yeah, guys, that was the new episode of Nintendo vs. Sega. See you later.